What is going on, lads, and welcome back to a brand new episode of the FIFA 21 Next Gen Everton Career Mode. The last episode was absolutely unreal. If you've not watched it, please, I'd advise you to go watch it now before I spoil anything. And for the people that's already watched it, what an episode it was. We managed to bring back Wayne Rooney, managed to bring back Romelu Lukaku. This describes me wearing this beat-down Everton shirt, which I've worn way too much. It's got Lukaku on the back. Yes, he's a Chelsea player, but I love this shirt. And then I've got the Wayne Rooney one in the background. We just had to rep them both number 10s. Me giving Wayne Rooney number 10 and Romelu Lukaku 17 from what I used to have when he was on loan from Chelsea. But I'm absolutely buzzing and excited to get into this episode. But off the back of last episode, I did leave you at the end of the episode saying that I want to try and sign a centre-half before the window ends. We have only got, 4 hours left. And I managed to do a lot of scouting, a lot of transfer offers, and I've come to one conclusion. If you're on the transfer hub, Simon Kier. I think that's how you say it. We did have a lot of centre-halves behind the scenes on the shortlist that I tried going through, transfer offers, wages, and trying to find the right centre-half, including like the overall age. And I just come to the conclusion of Simon Kier. I don't know why I chose this man, because I can't really say it. I'm hoping Kier's right. It sounds right in my head, but I've probably butchered it. But he is 31 years of age, 80 overall, which is decent. Like I said, I wanted kind of want to fit in until Ben Godfrey catches up, because he's only, 76, 75 rated, making a lot of mistakes. So hopefully this man can better him just until Ben Godfrey gets better. But the problem is, with this deal, if I wanted to keep it within the budget of like 10 million, I want to spend just so I've got enough wages, I had to try and offer a player. And they come back saying they wanted 4 million, which was amazing, but they wanted Tom Davies. A player I don't really want to get rid of, because, I mean, he's not the greatest of footballers, but I love him. Like, he's an Evertonian, he's a toffee through and through, so I didn't really want to get rid of him. But for me to bring this player in, and like I said before, I'm just overloading central midfielder positions. I've just had to do it, lads. So now it's time to hopefully get the wages done. If I butcher this, I am completely stuffed. So I am going to try my hardest to get this one done. But now the Simon Kier, I'm never really going to get used to that. The deal is done. He only wanted 59 grand a week, which just, I mean, I can't complain at that. Important squad role, which it will be until obviously Ben Godfrey catches up, which I doubt he will this season, because I'm only going to be playing one season. FIFA 22 is out soon, so I'm pretty sure Kier is going to be like the number one centre-half. But with this deal done, that does mean, unfortunately, Tom Davies is out of the club officially, which I didn't really want. I said this start of career mode, I didn't really want him out, but it was the only way to bring him in, so swings and roundabouts with that deal. But one thing we do need to change is number. For some reason, in my head, whenever I do it Everton career mode, I always retire the number 3 just because of Leighton Baines. I think I'll always be like that, just because I'll always class him as a club legend, and I can't see anyone replacing him in the number 3. Like, I really can't in my head. But we'll pick number 5. I think that's a nice deal for him. We'll go through development and everything like that, and then that should be it with the squad from now to the end of the season. I'm happy with the transfers we've brought in. And with those additions in the club, this is how the team is looking. Like I said, me bringing in Lukaku, I've had to go for a 4-man attack, which that attack just looks unreal. We've got Richie, we've got on form Edwards, Calvert-Lewin, and then Lukaku to add to the goals. That is going to be lethal this season. Central midfield, we've gone from a 3 to a 2, so we've gone with Ward-Prowse and Allen. I feel like the best fit. Unfortunately, Allen's going to have this yellow exclamation mark, which is going to really bug me, because it's a CDM and it takes, I think, 171 weeks to bring to a centre mid, which I don't understand, but yeah, we're just going to have to put up with it. And then the defence is looking a lot better. We've got Kier to upgrade from Ben Godfrey. Like I said, Ben Godfrey, 75 rated, made too many mistakes. So lovely addition, I'm hoping anyway. And then Trippier, obviously a lot of people said they wanted to replace the right back because Coleman and Max Evans wasn't good enough. So do you know what? I agree. He's actually been incredible for the past couple of games we've played him. And this is a bench I've decided to go with. It's a decent looking bench. We've got James Rodriguez to back up Edwards. So I didn't really need to bring in Reece Nelson. So yeah, that was L on my behalf, but nothing I can't really complain on. I've got Moise Kean. Not the greatest to have a single striker to back up two strikers, but it is what it is. We've got Wayne Rooney. I'm still buzzing about that, you know. Ryan Gravenberch, and then obviously Coleman Godfrey, Virginia, just because I feel like it's a written rule to have a goalkeeper on there. But that team, I'm really happy with. But now transfer deadline day is officially over. It's on to the next month, February. We have now got in this month Aston Villa at home. We've got Newcastle away and Manchester United at home. So in this month, I'll probably play Manchester United and Newcastle just because I feel like they're the most interesting fixtures. And then we've got Aston Villa. I'll simulate that. So we are back to playing two away fixtures. Obviously, I didn't within the past two episodes because it were transfers and I wanted to get them over and done with. So we're back to playing two games now. So hopefully we don't drop stupid points. But before we get into any games, this is how the table is looking at the start of the episode. We are still top. I don't know how. This is an absolute miracle. We are 2 points ahead of Manchester United. They've actually played a game above us, so we are a game in hand. We've got them this month. That's going to be mental. It's still infuriating missing them 3 losses. It is what it is, though. Hopefully we don't get any in today's episode. And let's start it off with a game against Aston Villa. We are at home, so hopefully that favours us with 3 points. I highly doubt it. We are playing the strongest 11, Lukaku getting his debut, Kier's getting his debut, and Wayne Rooney is on the bench. He's already made his debut, no? But that's the team I'm going to play. Let's not drop any points, lads. Is he here? Is he? It's not an episode without him scoring. With Lukaku inside of him, that's not bothering him whatsoever. Still wants the spotlight. He's scored a goal. I would love to know who assisted it, by the way. Because, is it Edwards? What a bit of player. Come on, whip it in. Why are we not using DCL and Lukaku's high? Yes, Lukaku, go on. On your debut, son. Oh, has he not scored that? I mean, have we not scored? But it would have been an absolute fairy tale if Lukaku scored, dear. If I'm being honest, not the most entertaining game, but 3 points nevertheless. Calvert-Lewin scoring in the 45th minute. Nothing else really happening. I am so gutted Lukaku missed that chance, but it is what it is. It's 3 points. Got to be happy with that. Portugal have just come in and offered me the job. Obviously, I'm not going to take it because this is an Everton one, and let's be honest, FIFA 22 that soon, so I couldn't really make time for Portugal. But I would love to do it. I would love to take Ronaldo to the World Cup and winning the World Cup, but unfortunately, today is not the day, and this series isn't the series, so I apologise. But moving on to the next game, we have got Newcastle away at St James's Park. I have noticed they're playing five at the back. This game isn't going to be fun. I am playing the same team. It is the strongest 11, so hopefully we can break down that defence, which, I mean, FIFA make it practically impossible to break down a five at the back. But hopefully this game, we actually can. I mean, I'm going to try and abuse the height. It's just whether I can actually get the ball whipped in. Probably should have played DCL here. It's worked it out either way. Oh, come on. Keep the ball. Nice. Come on. Edwards. It's my favourite two yet again, but this time it's DCL assisting Edwards. What is going on? The love for these two is unreal. Like, I can't exaggerate that enough. These two, I might actually get an Everton shirt with Edwards on back. I'm not going to do that, but this is unreal. Great tackle, Olgate. Great tackle. Come on, break. Yes. Edwards, go on. DCL's making that run. I see Richie, though. Okay, it's not played Richie whatsoever. I mean, I love the partnership, lads, but can we at least pass to other players?
Alan McAdally keeping us right up to date. Oh, good strike. Oh, from miles out.
I did not expect that. James Ward-Prowse. Oh, my God. I would say that's the goal of the series, but I just don't know. I'm pretty sure we scored some bangers, like the free kick from James Rodriguez. I didn't expect it. I thought we were going to get tackles. I thought I'd pop one, see what happens. And oh, my God. James Ward-Prowse, lads, is not just a set-piece specialist. Oh, absolutely unreal. Great tackle. Oh my God, Alan. Unreal. Unreal commitment. Can have it back. Lukaku, have it. Is it time? Is it? It is. It's Romelu Lukaku. I mean, technically his debut, but boys. I mean, even a shot. No. Look, get in. Get in. Oh, I knew I picked the right shirt to wear. Like, I was debating whether to wear the Lukaku or the Rooney one. But honestly, I did not think that ball from Alan were going to go through. I thought this just wasn't Lukaku's day. Get in. I don't even know what to say about this lad. He is unreal. Plays that ball to Lukaku as well. Could he win another run here? Great ball. Alan's in box. Can he get the goal he deserves? Oh, honestly, Alan is, ever since I've moved into the central midfield position, he's just unreal, winning every single ball whatsoever. Absolute bulldog. That is full time. We did win 3-0 away from home at St James' Park. We've just beat Newcastle in their own ground, and Steve Bruce probably still won't get sacked. The team played absolutely incredible that game. Like, I can't really say anything about Kier just because, I mean, Ireland were doing everything for him, but everyone else, unreal. But now on to the final game. The schedule never stops. This could be a massive game when it comes to our title race. Manchester United, the team at second and close on our heels. Hopefully we can beat these. I know last time we played him, I'm pretty sure we got absolutely humiliated. So let's not let him let that happen again. Lukaku, it's pretty much the same lineup. So there's nothing much really to mention. But please, lads, just don't get humiliated again. Good ball. Edwards is through. Lukaku. He's got past his man, so I'll play it merely. Just make sure he's not offside. What a save, De Gea. How has he saved that? I already had in my mind what I wanted to do as soon as Lukaku scores. But what a save.
Huge prize. It's imperative to keep that momentum. Oh, he's given
it. I am an idiot. I am an idiot. I thought Rashford were going to cut back, but he just never did. This is going to be huge as well. Like, momentum's all been in my way, but I know as soon as they score this, if they do, it's just going to swing right back at it. Jordan Pickford, mate, I've never needed you so much in my life. Please, Bruno Fernandes. Just an unreal penalty. Just an unreal penalty. Do you know what? We'll ignore it and move on, right? We'll do that. Come on, we've got a height advantage here. We've got so many tall players. Simon Kier, maybe get your head onto that. Oh, it's DCL instead. Oh, Rashford's beat us to it. We've managed to win it back with DCL. Lovely commitment. They've got Phil Jones playing. How are we not winning already, boys? Good tackle, Alan. Honestly, lad. Can't praise you enough. Cannot praise you enough. DCL. Surely a goal. Surely. Just to make sure. Oh, my God. I'm an idiot. I hate myself. I actually hate myself, you know. Sack me right now. What have I just tried doing here? And they're going to score from this as well, aren't they? They're going to score. I hate myself so much. I'm an idiot. I'm an actual idiot. That's the last time I ever tried to do that again. I just didn't think Calvert-Lewin could score from that like kind of angle. But looking back at it now, I probably should have risked it. Just didn't reach Lukaku and then they've just gone up counter and scored. If I lose the title because of this game right here, mark my words, I'm not saying anything just in case it does actually happen. Come on, don't let him in. How's Daniel James outstrength Mason Holgate like that? That probably could have been a pen. Is that free? No, thank God. Bruno Fernandes. What?
Well, that could be his final rebuke, I think, and the referee's making that absolutely clear.
Well, I like that, Derek. Good refereeing. Nice and strong. Told the player exactly
what he was thinking. This could be game over, and I don't even know what happened. Is he going to go the same side? He has as well. Why is that a penalty? Why? Yes, I've got a handball on, but even through that replay, it's not even touched his hand. I don't understand. I thought Bruno Fernandes saved us from conceding. Now he's actually scored against us. Mate, we are going to need an absolute miracle here. This is my luck. This is my luck this game. Romelu Lukaku's missing that. He would never miss. If we're 0-0, he's scoring that. Lukaku, get it, box. Good ball. Miss score this one. Yes, finally. Come on, 3-1. Get the ball. Lukaku, finally. Mate, honestly, I thought we'd have bottled that one as well. Thank God that's going in. Come back. Could be on. Not getting too excited, but it could be on. Lukaku scored 2. Oh my God, it's 3-2. What a lovely bit of build-up. I am sweating so much. Marcus Edwards with another assist. If I bring this back and somehow win, like, I'd be somewhat happy with a draw, but if I win this, oh my God. Fred. Can they convert? That's come back out window. Bruno Fernandes yet again. How has Fred done that? How has he controlled the ball so close to him like that? I brought 2 players out to him and he's just done that. That's come... I'm fuming. I am absolutely fuming with this game. What more can I do? Honestly, what more can I do? I am missing some absolute sitters. This actually could be 4-4 right now if Lukaku scored both of them chances. Come on. Please, EA. Please, it's 4-3. Give me a chance. Please, you've done me over so much in this game. Don't do it again.
Until they have a goal
on
their future, they're giving it a go.
That was it.
So there goes the final whistle, and this hasn't gone at all.
I have been
a defeat here, Lee. What did you make of it?
Well, I can't put into words. Yeah, Bruno, mate. I'm livid. How have I not won that? Romelu Lukaku at the start of the game missed an absolute sitter on a volley. So that's 4-4. And then Romelu Lukaku, what right now? Missed a header, I think, that come off the post. Or a volley off the post. I think it... Come on, is it fair for me to feel done over? Or did I just play awful? That honestly could have been one of the craziest comebacks of my life. But anyway, moving on. This is a table. It looks like Manchester United lost the past 2 fixtures. So we've now got a bit more of a lead. We are 4 points ahead, which I'm happy about. It makes that loss feel a bit better. Not really. But this is where I am going to end today's episode. It's been a rollercoaster of emotions. Lukaku's managed to get in the score sheet, which has been unreal. Could have been included in one of the most craziest comebacks, but it wasn't to be because EA love Manchester United. But moving away from that, if you have enjoyed, please leave a like and subscribe if you're new around it. It's free. It goes a long way. I may potentially, this is just a thought, upload like 3 episodes of Career Mode a week just until FIFA 22, just because, I mean, I need to get the series done. I'll hate it if it comes to FIFA 22 come out and I'm like 2 episodes away from completing it. So I really want to do what I need to do to get the series done. But yeah, like I said, thank you all for watching. Stay safe, take care, and I'll see you all in the next video. Later.